Hey everyone, Johnny here. In this Q&A video, we're going to look at a question from YouTube user OnkAndKa64, who asked if it was possible to have random extrusion off of random faces. Let's take a look at how we could accomplish that. For this example, I'm using Blender 2.93 Alpha, built as of 3/15/21. Here I've got a grid object and a cube. I'm going to instance the cube on the grid object, and I'm going to put a geometry node tree on the grid object to drive the height of the cube. There's really two main parts to the user's question. First, selecting random vertices to extrude from. So let's look at how we might do that. If I add an attribute randomize node and call it select, this is going to create for each point a random floating value between 0 and 1. We can use this to select our points. What I'm going to do is split this window and change this half into the new spreadsheet window. That way we can see what kind of values we're creating. And you see here, I have my select column with its random values. The next thing I want to do is I want to turn these select values into an option of whether or not we're going to select that vertex. In order to do this, I'm going to use an attribute math node, and I'm going to set it to greater than. So my A value will be the select attribute, and I'll set my B value to a float. For right now, I'm going to set it to 0.5, and then set the result back to the select group. As you can see, our select values are now either 0 or 1, because greater than is going to return 1 if the A value is greater than the B value, and 0 if it's not. So now we can use this attribute to select our vertices. I'm going to select these two and join them together. The next thing we want to do is create our random heights. Once again, I'll use an attribute randomize node. It'll be a floating point that replaces or creates an attribute called height. Again, we get a height column with random values. To apply our selection to our height, we're simply going to multiply the select value against the height value. Where the select is 1, we'll get the height. Where the select is 0, we'll get 0. So I'll do another attribute math node, multiply, select, and I'll call this output. So now under output, you should have attributes with 0 or with some random value between 0 and 1. Now that we have an output to drive our scaling, we can go ahead and start instancing our cube. So I'm going to add a point instance node, point it to our cube. In the current implementation of the spreadsheet editor, as soon as you add a point instance node, you'll no longer have the data for your mesh. So if you need to go back and see the attributes for your mesh, just remove the point instance from the tree. We then want to add a point scale. And to fill in our scale, I'm going to use an attribute combine. I want to leave the x and y values 1. And I want to set z as an attribute and set that to our output attribute. I'm going to put this in scale. And actually, because I've put this in scale, I don't need this point scale node here. So now as you can see, we've got objects that are either 0 or a random value. So here's one solution for the problem. One quick adjustment we could do, which would get rid of these flat squares, is to change this attribute math node to a point separate node. In this case, we would use the select attribute as our mask, and then use the point separate to determine which geometry gets instanced. And then in this case, we would just directly use the height attribute in our attribute combine. So in this solution, you wouldn't get cubes with 0 height. You just wouldn't get those ones at all. Either way, it's all depending on what you're going for. Finally, I would drag a few inputs to my group input so that I could control this from my modifier panel. Here, I could drag the selection level, Here I could drag the maximum height. And then perhaps I could drag the seed inputs as well. So now with this setup, I could choose how much or how little is being chosen. I could choose the maximum height, and then I could choose the seed that's determining the randomness. So I hope this answers the question, or at least gives you some ideas to create something awesome for yourself. Make sure to like and subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you next time.